everybody's coming out here for the Manny Pacquiao Media Day. Look around, Truth, look around. What you got? You got reporters, you got cameras, you got video cameras, TV crews, ICC, CBS, NBC. You have everyone. Manny Pacquiao, Joshua Clady coming up March 13th, and we're out here for Media Day.
Joshua Clady, on your many trips to Ghana, I know you stopped there on your way back to Tel Aviv. So at this particular time, don't be truculent with me, LA. I love your stuff, AOL Fan Heist. You do your best video interviews in the game. You're the young up-and-coming protege of myself, Howard Cosell. And I am the best in the business, no doubt.
How you been, Mike? How's life?
I'm good, man. I'm just pumped up about this fight. You know, it's a funny thing. I'm sure like you, like me, like everybody, we're all disappointed that Mayweather and Pacquiao didn't pan out. But you know what? Now we got two big promotions going, and boxing, I think, is going wilder than ever. So it's not bad.
Do you think it's Manny's last fight?
I don't think so. I'll tell you why. I could envision, Ellie. I tried to squeeze that out of him the other night in the little Thai restaurant, but he talked. What all he would say was, he thinks about it. I think a lot depends on does he win the election, even though that's more or less a part-time job to be in Congress. One thing he told me that I thought was most interesting was I asked him, you know, Bob Arum says he'll someday be president of the Philippines, not Bob Arum, Manny.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And he said, I don't want to be president. He said, that's not my ambition. If I was in Congress and I could help the poor people and help them get jobs and housing, I think it depends. If he's in a very tough race. I asked Manny what's the most important thing about his opponent. He said he's a billionaire. Well, you know, with politics, there are the same as here, so it takes money. But if Manny wins the election, I could see him. Yeah, we can't get run over. That would be some new video for the fan house. But if he wins the election, I could see him. I could see him stepping out of boxing, but I think he'll come back shortly. In other words, if he does retire, I think it'll be a short retirement. He's only 31. We got guys out here that are 45 and 50 fighting. Holyfield got a one-fight license the other day.
Let me ask you this.
Sure.
Looking out here, we're out here at Media Day. It's packed with reporters. What's the mood like out here?
I'll tell you, this guy is, you know, you're an internet maven. This guy has the biggest internet following, I think, of any fighter. He came along at the right time, the right generation. He's 31. You guys in your 20s, your 30s, this is your guy, man. I had 100,000 page views on examiner.com yesterday just in one day. Now, I don't get that every day. I'd be lying to you if I said that, but everyone's hyped up about Mayweather, about, you know, all the Mayweathers, about Pacquiao using that. Do you have any A-meth? Do you use that either? Because I think maybe the Mossad uses that. That's why they can't be beat. But all the controversy and all this, to me, it's good for boxing. It's like it's a circus anyway.
It sells.
Yeah.
Controversy sells.
Right, attention sells. Controversy sells. That's why the media is here. That's why we're going to have 40,000 people in Dallas.
Who do you think is next for Manny after Clady?
Well, you know, that's an interesting situation because, as you know, I find it very interesting that Mayweather and Mosley have a rematch clause. Now, I don't think that Shane Mosley asked for that. I think Floyd Mayweather demanded it. So if their fight is a good competitive fight, which I hope it will be, I think they might do it again. I think you'll see Mayweather and Pacquiao happen, but maybe not until late in 2011.
So there you have it, Manny Pacquiao's Media Day. From outside the wild card, I'm Eli Sekbak reporting.